Early in the Clone Wars, a specialized squad of clone commandos, including commando snipers, pilots, and ordnance specialists, were sent into the underworld planet of Ord Mantell to escort an incredibly crucial diplomatic package, which was intended for Chancellor Palpatine. These brave clone commandos agreed to give their lives to ensure that this parcel was delivered safely to the Supreme Chancellor, believing that it was one of the most vital packages to the survival of the Republic. After much tragedy and bloodshed, however, the package was opened, and inside was something that was definitely not worth the incredible sacrifice of the clone commandos. So, I'm going to break down the story of the last clone commando left standing to deliver this vital package to Chancellor Palpatine. Before we get into it, make sure to smash the subscribe button for more awesome Star Wars lore content. The story begins inside of a briefing room at Republic Intelligence Headquarters in a top secret location. A yellow-trimmed ARC intelligence clone begins briefing a squad of clone commandos led by Trooper Sarge. The ARC Trooper intelligence officer begins to tell the commandos of the incident that occurred only one night prior to the meeting, where a group of renegade Trandoshan bounty hunters were able to intercept a package of extreme diplomatic importance, which was intended to be delivered directly to Supreme Chancellor Palpatine himself. The ARC intelligence officer then firmly orders his men to make sure that this object inside of the package cannot be sold to the Separatists because of its incredible importance. Commando Sarge is confused by this, asking the intelligence officer, "Wouldn't this be a better job for an ARC trooper?" The ARC trooper responds, telling Sarge, "Negative." The exchange is going to happen on Ord Mantell, with busy streets and lots of civilian interference, and for this reason, two elite teams of clone commandos are needed. Sarge quickly accepts the terms of his mission before asking his officer, "Sir, any idea what's in the package?" The ARC trooper hastily responds, telling Sarge that he doesn't know what's inside the package, but firmly tells him that they must die to ensure that the parcel is delivered safely to Chancellor Palpatine. Sarge and his men quickly agree to the mission before being sent off to the criminal hive of Ord Mantell. We then cut straight to a roadway on Ord Mantell, where a large group of Trandoshan scoundrels are gliding along in their ground cars. Inside the middle green car is a Trandoshan who has his scaly arm placed firmly on top of the package, which the clone commandos must extract. Luckily, Blue Sniper Commando is able to lock his sights firmly onto the locked package with his scope, reporting his findings to Sarge. Once Sarge receives the location of the package, he orders his men to thin out the amount of Trandoshans that they will have to deal with any way they can. Once Sarge ensures that only very few civilians will be in the line of fire, he orders Green Ordnance Specialist Commando to fire his weapon, sending a missile ringing through the crowded streets below before decimating the first Trandoshan car, turning it into a thick ball of red and yellow fire. While this is happening, Blue Infantry Commando is moving on foot towards the Trandoshan cars in full civilian clothing, wearing the disguise of a local mechanic. Immediately after the first car is destroyed, the Blue Infantry Commando rips his engineer disguise off and attempts to fire on the Trandoshans in the second car. Unfortunately, the Trandoshan sitting in the back of the car protecting the package is well armed and fires a wrist rocket viciously into the chest of the commando, killing him immediately. As this is happening, the back Trandoshan car brutally runs over the members of the Blue Commando Squad, leaving them badly injured before turning their orange vehicle around and dropping a load of blast charges behind them. As you can probably guess, these commandos were torn limb from limb by the blast, killing them all in an instant. Such a sad way to go out. The Trandoshan criminals cheer as they watch the red flames expand from the side of the blast, fleeing into the distance. Sarge and the commandos on top of the roof, however, maintain a line of sight on the Trandoshans, with Blue Sniper Commando placing his sights firmly on the head of the driver. As the brave commando pulls the metallic trigger of his weapon, the barrel of his blaster flashes with a bright burst of energy before his shot reaches the escaping car, obliterating all of the filthy Trandoshans inside. Sadly, only four clone commandos are left standing on this ruthless mission. Sarge quickly realizes that they are heading for the industrial yards before loading his men onto a nearby transport and zooming through the streets of Ord Mantell to reach the Trandoshans. Once the commandos reach the industrial yards, they quickly fan out to search the surrounding area for any trace of the Trandoshans and, more importantly, the package. Eventually, White Commando comes across a door and enters an override code into the keypad to break his way inside. Once he manages to get inside, the Trandoshans, along with the package and a small unit of B1 battle droids, spot the trooper before tearing his armor and his body inside to shreds with a flurry of red blaster bolts. Only three brave men now remain. Once Sarge and the others hear this, they rush over to the same building and he lobs a high-power EMP blast charge inside, disabling all electronics and, more importantly, the unit of battle droids. As the circuits of the B1 units are quickly fried by the EMP charge, the three remaining commandos open fire, spraying the entire room with a barrage of blue blaster bolts. Sarge then orders Green Commando to breach the nearby door, sending a massive blast tearing through the nearby area and into the next room. The three Trandoshan criminals now have their slimy backs up against the wall, with the three commandos powering forward towards them. Unfortunately, Green Commando is viciously killed by a flurry of incoming fire, but Blue Sniper Commando is able to blast one of the Trandoshans through the chest, killing him in return. After diving into cover with Blue Sniper, Sarge lobs yet another blast charge at the feet of one of the Trandoshans, leaving him to watch the tiny device before being immediately disintegrated by the blast. The commandos breathe a small sigh of relief, believing that they are now in the clear for the time being, but unfortunately, with their backs turned, a yellow-jacketed Trandoshan, holding the package, appears from the shadows and brutally kills Blue Sniper Commando by shooting him in the back with a powerful bolt of energy from his wrist blaster. Sarge cries out in pain as his final remaining brother succumbs to his injuries, but focuses his mind, realizing that the mission must be completed at all costs. As the disgraceful Trandoshan is attempting to escape with the package through a nearby door, Sarge leaps up from the ground and strangles the scaly neck of the creature before beating him to a pulp and eventually horrifically slicing his throat cleanly open with his wrist blade. The Trandoshan, of course, dies a horribly painful death, but Sarge has no sympathy for the creature who helped to kill all seven of his brothers who joined him on the mission. Sarge is relieved that his nightmare mission is finally over, but can't help but be absolutely saddened and furious at the needless cost to his brothers' lives. Sarge then marches out of the Ord Mantell alleyway with his armor smoldering and badly damaged, but above all, he has completed the mission. He has successfully obtained the incredibly important package for his commander-in-chief, the Supreme Chancellor. Painful thoughts rush through his mind, but he must not let them take over and must dedicate himself totally and completely to the Republic, even if only to honor the brave sacrifices of the men he lost on this tragic mission. What a brave soldier. Let me know down below if Sarge is now one of your favorite soldiers after this incredibly brave effort. Also, make sure you see the follow-up to his story in the description down below after this video because it is truly heartbreaking. To end the story, we return straight back to the Chancellor's office on Coruscant. Masamita brings the fateful package directly to Palpatine's desk as he is signing a piece of legislation recently passed through the Senate. Palpatine doesn't even remember asking for a package to be delivered to him oddly, but opens the metal box anyway. Inside, what he finds will truly shock you. Instead of being an incredibly important document or piece of technology which could change the tide of the war, it is simply a gift from the diplomats of the planet Malastare, which is literally just a small artifact. Instead of keeping and displaying the artifact which seven men died to bring him, Chancellor Palpatine simply tells Masamita to place the object inside of a storage closet because he has more important matters to deal with. This is honestly so heartbreaking to hear. The object is then placed inside of the storage chamber along with hundreds of other identical boxes never to be seen, touched, or thought of ever again. Truly sad that these clones made an incredibly brave sacrifice to bring the Chancellor this object, only to have it placed away into storage, never to be seen again. So that is the story of the clone commando who was the last remaining in his squad and was able to deliver what he thought was an incredibly important package to Chancellor Palpatine, only to have it stored away as an afterthought. Thanks so much for watching, really hope you enjoyed the video. Cheers guys, hope to see you in the next one.